Hello, my name is Zammy. I work as a wiki editor for the Age of Oblivion mod, and today I want to explain how to install the mod onto your system. So, first, what you need to do is to get the mod. If you are in the Age of Oblivion Discord, it can be found in the announcements channel. And Piper Mac, when he puts up a new update, will include a link to the mod. It is this link right here. It will always say at the moment AOO-alpha underscore latest. Even if he updates to a new version, it will still say latest. So go ahead and click on the link. And that will bring you to this page. To download it, click on the three dots over here and download as zip. Go ahead and save the file. And we'll go to the downloads here. The download is several gigs worth of data, so go ahead and give it time to download. Okay, it took a little bit of time, but our download is finally done. You can see it's 4.4 gigabytes. So let's go ahead and open the file. Now you can use the unzip option in Windows. I prefer not to, but that is just my personal opinion. I will instead open 7-zip, which is free if you want to download it and install it. Okay, well, let's close that now. So let's go ahead and open our zip here. You have the data and the mods. We'll set that aside. Now, what you want to do is go ahead and install it into your Steam client. What I do is to create a copy of 7 Days to Die, rather than install it into the regular one, so that when Fun Pimps pushes out an update, it doesn't overwrite any mod files, it doesn't cause any conflicts with the mod, and you can still continue to play with the mod. So you find your 7 Days to Die, go ahead and just copy it, and then paste it. Let's go over here. Paste. This will take a little bit of time because it's going to be copying several gigs worth of data. So I'll be back then. Okay, looks like we're almost done. It only took a few minutes. Okay, we are done. So you will get a 7 Days to Die copy. Go ahead and rename that. And in this case, I'm going to name it to AOO. So go into that folder you just created, your copy, and you'll have a mods folder, which, yes, these are old mods. I'll go ahead and take those out. And there shouldn't be anything installed other than vanilla into the prefab, so we're good there. So go ahead and drop the info from mods. There's going to be a whole bunch of folders into your mods folder. You could also just drop the mods folder into the folder, your main copy folder, and it would go ahead and merge everything. This is going to take a bit because it is a couple of gigs to copy over. So I will be right back. Okay, so my system was pretty quick about it, got everything copied over. If anything is missing, double check now between your zip file. You will have issues if anything is missing. Now we'll go over to the data folder and we'll go back up in our zip. And then there's the prefabs. And as I said before, you can just drop it into an open space. And it should merge it directly into your prefabs folder. You go to date modified, Here's all of the AOO blocks right here. All the way down to here. Those are all loaded in. Now, we can close our zip file. And we can close this. Now we need to go and get Steam to see our copy of 7 Days to Die. For that, we're going to go to Games, and we are going to add a non-Steam game to my library. And then just go to Browse. And then you're going to point to that folder that you just created. AOO, open. And then do the 7 Days to Die EXE. You could do the EAC as well. Completely up to you. So there's that one. So we will add selected programs. So then you will get another copy of 7 Days to Die. And you will notice that it does not have the spaces in the name like the original does. Then to make things a little bit easier, you can right click on it, go to Properties, and then you can go ahead and change the name of it so that you can see it very quickly as to which one's which. So this one's 7 Days to Die AOO, and this one is 7 Days to Die Modded, which is the other folder that I had there. So then now all you have to do to run Age of Oblivion is go to your Age of Oblivion in Steam and click play. And it will take a little bit for it to come up initially. It does take quite a while for it to load everything in. But then you will see that it's a completely different splash screen, and you will know that you have loaded it in correctly. And I will show you in just a moment. And here we are. Here is the splash screen for Age of Oblivion. Age of Oblivion Alpha 2.8. We've got it installed. I hope you enjoyed. My next one will be on how to install it onto a server. At least on a Windows server. It's pretty much the exact same setup, and you will have to have them installed completely on both sides in order for it to work. Have a good one!